Hello everyone. Today I'm going to talk about how does a hotel build up the brand loyalty of its customers. Actually, this topic is a very important question in the hotel industry. So let me show you my presentation. In fact, my presentation has been divided into three main parts. First of all, I will introduce some terms which will be mentioned in my next presentation. And the second one, I will talk about some findings which I have found them from the research. And finally, I will give you main two suggestions which can be used in the practical business strategy. So let's start. There are totally three main terms which will be mentioned in my next presentation. The first of all is brand personality. You know, in this term, we can consider the brand as a human. You know, the human have all kinds of emotions, and the similar as the brand has all kinds of the elements, such as the service quality, the customer satisfaction, the outcome favorability, and stuff like that. Put all of the elements together, they are the brand personality. And next is the brand loyalty. Brand loyalty, we can consider that it is how much possibility a customer desire to rebook or rebuy the same brand hotel. So this is the brand loyalty. And the next one is the brand familiarity. The brand familiarity, we can think of that it is a level of the perception about a hotel brand of a customer. So this is the brand familiarity. We will use the terms in the next presentation. Let me show you a framework. I found this framework from others' research. And the first one will talk about the service about the brand. And this brand and this framework can show you the relationship between the brand personality and the behavioral loyalty. And in my research, the behavioral loyalty can be considered as the customer loyalty. So we can say that the brand personality will have the positive effects on the affective loyalty, and then they will have the same effects on the cognitive loyalty, and finally they will influence the behavioral loyalty, the customer loyalty, positively. But as long as the brand personality happened, the affective and the cognitive loyalty will happen by the 100%. So we can consider that the brand personality will influence the customer loyalty directly. But in the whole relationship, the brand familiarity will influence the relationship between the personality and the loyalty as a moderator. And based on the lots of researches, we can find that a high level brand familiarity can be more efficient. Efficient in the whole relationship. So this is the relationship between the personality and the customer loyalty and the brand familiarity. Next one is about the environment. You know, the environment is another important elements in the hotel industry. And I have shown you a big framework, and the origin is the ambient atmospherics. And we can say that the ambient atmospherics will have the positive effects on the favorable emotional experience. And the emotional experience will have the same effects, the positive or the negative effects on the hotel image and the guest satisfaction. Also we can say that the hotel image will have the positive effects on the guest satisfaction. So we can consider that the favorable emotional experience will have the same influence as the hotel image to influence the guest satisfaction. So from all of the framework, we can consider that the ambient atmospherics will have the effect on the favorable emotional experience, and then they will influence the customer satisfaction. And the finally, the hotel loyalty will be built up. If all of the hotels under the same brand, so the whole brand loyalty will be built up. And based on this framework, we can see that the ambient atmospheres, I mean the hotel environment, is also important in the whole hotel industry. And the next one is about, based on the last theory, we can see that a very common example. As you may know, almost hotel will use the low temperature and clean music in the summer, but in winter they will use the high temperature and exciting music. So this is a common example. We have seen that this situation is based on the last theory. I mean the relationship between the hotel environment and the customer loyalty. And next is about the service. Service is also important, and it is one of the environment of brand personality. And as you may know, the service quality is a dynamic element. So sometimes the service fails will happen. And if the service fails happened, servicer have to do something to offer the service recovery to remedy the service fails. So let me show you another framework. This framework can express the service recovery, service recovery to remedy the customer loyalty. And in this framework, we can find that the outcome favorability and the satisfaction with service recovery, we call it ISR. And this is OF. So OF and the SSR are the medium elements in the whole relationship. So we also can consider that the service recovery will influence the customer loyalty directly. And this can show you the service recovery is so important. And also, especially when the service fails happened. And I have found two practical suggestions from my research. In the whole hotel industry, for managers, they need to do some practical business strategy to improve their brand personality and the brand familiarity. Based on these two elements, they will get a high customer loyalty. But for servicers, they need to try the best to offer the high quality service. If sometimes the service fails happened by accident, they need to try their best to offer the service recovery to maintain their customer loyalty. So this is all my presentation, and this is my reference list. Thank you so much. And are there some questions?
Yes, I have the question. Have you ever to live in a different hotel and think about your very want to try to again living again?
Yes, for me, my hobby is traveling to other area, especially in the different country. Actually, I have been in the Four Seasons and the Sheraton's and actually the Waldorf.
Okay.
I think you know. So all of them, I like the Four Seasons. It's so luxury.
Okay, thank you.
I have found, you can know the example I have mentioned. Maybe all of the hotels will use the common example. They will use the air conditioner to control the temperature and change all kinds of the music to maintain the customer loyalty. Because based on this iron will let me feel so comfortable and relaxed.
So that is why the hotel can more relationships with the customer and want the customer they want to try it again.
Yes.
Okay.
As long as the customer will have a nice experience, in the hotel.
Mm-hmm.
If they will travel again, they will rebook the same brand.
Okay.
The situation is similar as the, like the some handbag or the t-shirt, it's so similar. Just change the stuff as the hotel.
Thank you.
Can we have some more questions?
My question was like, is this research presentation going to be help you a little bit with your research? What you want to do in the future?
Was this
helpful?
In my next year, my major is hospitality management, and it have to be related to the hotel industry. And I do this research. I think it can help me to adapt the another study year. I mean the further study. So I think if I can finish all of the research about this topic, I think it will help me to be the suitable for the next year.
Your presentation was very good.
Thank you so much.
Do we have any other questions? Can you show the reference list again,
yes,
please? You gave a number of relationships explaining brand loyalty there. What surprised you over the course of your research? What was the most surprising finding?
I think actually, I think the relationship between the service recovery and the customer loyalty, this framework make me so surprised. Because
can you just explain that with an example? So you know, I'm a bit confused about service recovery, and I know you mentioned it before, but if you could just remind me and maybe give an example.
Okay, service recovery is a service when the service fails happened, and it can remedy the service fails.
For example,
if Takuya is my customer, and when I gave her a cup of glass, a glass of water, but by accident, I dropped down this on the floor, and first of all, I need to give him the apologize, and this is a kind of the service recovery. And another, maybe I will clean the floor and do another service. Maybe I will give him some presents and some gifts for my apologize. So all of this service is the service recovery, and this is an efficient way to maintain the customer loyalty.
Thank you so much.